Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I have another tutorial on how to schedule a preventive maintenance. Today we're going to go through how to schedule a yearly preventive maintenance. So when you open the database, this is the screen that you see. This is the main menu. So when you want to schedule a yearly maintenance, you go to the preventive maintenance screen and it shows you the portal for the dashboard, the preventive maintenance dashboard. So if you want to schedule a yearly maintenance, this is where you do it. All this is just reminders of the PMs that are due within a certain period. This for yearly, in 45 days, it gives you a reminder that a PM is due within 45 days. But for the email, it sends you within 3 days. So before you schedule a yearly maintenance, make sure that you have the equipment added in the database and you already populated the PM description on the database as well. So if you want to add the equipment, you can go in here and add the equipment. And then make sure you add the email as well. And you separate them by comma because you can add up to 10 emails. And in case you run a maintenance department that has 10 people or 7 people or 8 people, and you want a notification to be sent to them once the PM is due within a certain period, you want this to come in here and take this email and send email address and send it to them. All right, so after you're done with putting in the equipment, you can populate the PM list as well. The PM list is just a description of specific items that you want to maintain. So say you want to perform a particular task on a pump or a motor or a forklift, you can have the list of this however way you want to describe it. And then you link the forklift or the pump to that particular description. So all these blank spaces are supposed to have an equipment on it, linked to it. So the equipment is on the drop down, which is it populates through the drop down. And as you can see on the previous screen where I added the equipment. So once you're done with populating the PM list, you X out of it and then let's schedule a PM. Before we do that, we have 3 PM that are due within 45 days. So we'll go in there. When we go in there, you can see the 3 p.m. that are due. And once the three days get there, all this p.m. drops off. But if you want them to stop showing, and if you already completed p.m. ahead of time before the due date, you can come in here and click complete. And if you want to schedule a brand new p.m., you can just click schedule brand new p.m. on this checkbox right here. So right now we just want to schedule a yearly PM. So in order to do that, we scroll to the bottom of the page and we pick the equipment. It auto-populates the serial number and the equipment. We put in the PM description, the name of the maintenance tech. If we have a service company that's performing the task, we put it there, add notes. Here is a hyperlink. We can add a hyperlink if we have one. If we want to attach a document, we can do that here. And then we can add the parts. Say if you have a part that you use in performing the maintenance, you can add the parts right there. And then after you're done, you make sure you add, in order for the scheduling, the PM scheduling to be complete, you have to schedule a date. So assuming you want to do this, perform this PM 1 year from now, today is the 3rd, you can click this and it automatically calculates the from this year to the next year. So it calculates a year in advance. For this tutorial purpose, we want to backdate it so we can see the reminder and also the email that's been sent. Just for the tutorial purpose. So let's backdate this a year from now. So this is 3 days from now. 3 days, the due date is 3 days from today. So after we're done, after we completed the date, we're done with scheduling the yearly PM. Then we save and close. Notice that it's 3 PM that are due, but after I close the form and go back into it to refresh, it changed to 4 yearly PM due. So this timer right here, an email is sent every 5 seconds. So this PM has already been sent because it's past 5 seconds. So if you look at here, we have a PM that has already been sent to, a notification that has already been sent to my email. So that's it. If you want to know how to get this data or to purchase the database, the description is down below. If you want to customize it further, just let me know, send me an email, and I will get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you for staying to the end of this tutorial.